Successfully incorporating inquiry-based learning in the classroom requires teachers to make use of a toolkit of specific teacher skills that promote openness and curiosity. In this video, we'll examine many of these skills and show them in action. Let's begin. A big part of inquiry-based learning is that it allows the teachers and the students to go down paths of discovery that are completely unexpected. To be able to accomplish this, however, requires flexibility and patience from the teacher. It's easy to see the questions that students ask as distractions that have to be put aside in order to have time to cover all of the content.
How does the pulley work?
I'm sorry, we just don't have time to go over that.
But...
No, just stop.
Embracing these questions, however, can lead to powerful teachable moments. Students coming up with questions on their own is a wonderful thing, as that means that the student's motivation to learn more about that particular topic is high.
Miss T, how does a pulley work?
Basically, a pulley works by helping us lift a heavy
load. Andrea chooses not to put aside the student's question. She's being flexible by taking time to focus on this moment. But because time as an elementary school teacher is limited, this might mean that Andrea will have to find time later in the week to go over the student's question. Or she might have to extend her current lesson and push back a following lesson to another time. Another instance where teacher flexibility comes into play occurs when a student goes about solving a problem using an unexpected methodology. It can be tempting for teachers in these instances to steer the students towards the correct methodology or solution in order to save time or stay in line with the lesson plan.
No, that's not how it's done. Let me show you how to do it.
Here we can see how Andrea responds to a student going off the beaten track. These deviations brought on by the student, however, are not wrong and can lead to some very interesting moments. Andrea chooses to embrace the deviation. The role of the teacher during inquiry-based activities is that of the facilitator. Andrea here wants to open as many doors as possible for her students. She wants to encourage their thinking and promote dialogue so that they can understand and justify their decisions when playing. Andrea tries to stay away from closed questions. They tend to put an end to dialogue really fast.
I see that you've used inclined planes that are not very steep. Did that work for you?
Yes.
Okay.
Instead, Andrea pushes her students by making use of open-ended questions, asking students to explain why they think something didn't work, or to let them speculate what would happen if a variable changed, is a great way to develop her students' critical thinking skills.
What do you think the purpose was? Go ahead.
So that goes straight down, mm-hmm. So then they can make a barrier. So then
it can. To help her with this, she could always use the smarter science, predict, explain, observe, explain methodology. When students engage in inquiry-based learning, there is inevitably going to be some trial and error. Making mistakes and having solutions not work are good things. Like in real life, it often takes many failures to get to a successful solution. Failing should not be discouraged. It's a great way to learn.
If your design doesn't work the first time, is it the end of the world?
No.
Well, actually, if you fail now, you're probably gonna fail for the rest of your life. Frankly, failure is not an option.
Failing can, however, be discouraging to students and prevent them from wanting to continue trying. Andrea wants to cultivate the idea that failing is not a bad thing. Andrea's strategy to go about this is to set up proper expectations before starting any activity. Andrea wants the students to get used to the idea that if something doesn't work, it's good practice to stop, observe what didn't work, and then take the time to think of a solution.
I can't get him up.
Okay. Is that the end of the world class?
No.
I think this is a good time to stop.
Students can have trouble with this concept at first, but by nature, they have an intrinsic resilience to failure.
What do you think?
I think you should put the support a little higher.
Andrea also wants to let her students know that it's also okay for them to let go of an idea if they get stuck in a rut.
Liam, what do you think?
I think I'll try it.
Let's go ahead and try it.
Not all ideas work out in the end, and just because they've invested time into an idea, doesn't mean that that idea has to be seen to completion. It's inevitable that during inquiry-based learning activities, students will ask questions that teachers don't know the answer to. It can be scary and frustrating for teachers to go into an activity knowing that students will test the limits of their knowledge. Teachers don't have to know all of the answers.
A simple machine is a mechanical device that changes the direction or magnitude of a force. They use mechanical.
Many teachers are not engineers or biologists. That's fine. Not knowing all of the answers makes teachers look human and more relatable.
Let's get back to mechanical advantage for a moment. What this is a measure of the force amplification achieved by using something like a simple machine. It all has to do with the law of the lever, a lever being a movable bar that pivots on a fulcrum attached or positioned on or across a fixed point.
But instead of answering a question with, I don't know, it is possible instead to use, I don't know, as a starting point for deeper inquiry. Even without expertise, teachers can still offer lots of useful information about the process of asking good questions and finding answers efficiently. Here, Andrea is being asked a question that she doesn't know the answer to.
Can we use this book for support?
I don't know, I guess so. Let's try it out.
She does recognize, however, that because her class has been doing related inquiry activities, her and her student have the tools available to answer the question.
Great job, it worked.
We see a very powerful teachable moment where the student's questions has led to an entirely new spontaneous activity. Because it's the student's own question, the student is motivated to take ownership of the experiment and to figure out the answer. Andrea's role is to be the guide in the answer-finding process. She supports the students and gently nudges them in the directions that have a good chance of finding the answer. Here's another example where the student asks Andrea a question that she can't answer. Yes.
Do Egyptians use inclined plates to make a pyramid?
This question, however, is more knowledge-based and doesn't lend itself well to testing in class.
Let's do some research and find out.
Andrea can still create a teachable moment out of this by using this as an opportunity to have the student practice researching skills. Success in activity design is about sparking curiosity and allowing the students to feel good. Whatever the activity is, it needs to have a hook. A hook can be something like a story that has tension and the need for resolution. It can also be an element of surprise where a prop behaves in an unexpected way. These are elements that lead the students to want to know more. These are things that make it so that the students want to find out the answer. The final episode in this series focuses on the techniques that can be used to help students develop important inquiry-based learning skills.